When you think about the ugliest items in The Sims 4, what do you think about? Maybe these couches or wall decals from My First Pet Stuff. These weird recreational items from Growing Together. This toilet. This chandelier. Base game hutches. Silent Hill monster intestine looking arched balloons. Or maybe all of these. There are a ton of weird objects to choose from in The Sims 4, and today I want to use all of them to build a house. I want to try and make this house actually look good. And this video is sponsored by Factor75. Factor75 is a subscription-based service that delivers chef-quality, pre-made meals right to your doorstep. You can cut out the stress of meal planning, grocery shopping, and cleaning by enjoying their delicious meals that come together in minutes. Plus, they're now offering 2 free wellness shots with every order while your subscription is active. With their hassle-free meals, you can make sure you have something quick and nutritious on hand when you don't have time to worry about making lunch or dinner. And they have so many options to support your lifestyle, including keto, low-calorie, vegan, or vegetarian recipes. And they also have smoothies, which are my personal favorite. It's so easy to just grab when you're on the go. And meal plans range anywhere from 4 to 18 meals per week, meaning you could add or reduce the number of meals that you want depending on your specific needs. You can even skip a week if necessary. So check out Factor75 by clicking the link down in the description or by scanning the QR code on screen and use my code SYDMACFEB50 to get 50% off your first Factor75 box and receive 2 free wellness shots per order while your subscription is active. Thank you so much to Factor75 for sponsoring this video, and let's get back into it. So I think I'm also going to be building in my least favorite world today, which I'm sorry to say is Moonwood Mill. This is the one that comes with werewolves. Honestly, the world itself isn't even bad. I'm just a big lighting girly, and the lighting here always is just so dull. But actually, I think if we build in this corner here, it won't be so bad. So starting off with the outside, I went through and found a bunch of items that I thought were not so nice. We've got this base game sculpture here and this big sculpture from Get Together. I also saw this in the post that I made on Twitter. It's the Simply Simplicity leather art sofa from City Living. It's just so weird. I don't think I've ever used this item. Of course, we've got these items from Journey to Bad 2. There are a lot of Journey to Bad 2 items I like, but these ones with like all of the gear in there, I don't like. And we have the Eco Lifestyle recycling objects. Love the idea, but they're pretty ugly. So I think because we're gonna have so many weird items in here, we're gonna need to make an interesting looking shell. And I was thinking about taking the eco route. Since we're gonna be using items from Eco Lifestyle, we can try and make it an eco-focused house. And I was also thinking maybe this person could be an inventor. Maybe they're really into the handiness skill. So I'm going into this house creation with that mindset. I'm gonna add on my roofing at the top here, but I'm gonna bring in both of the adjusters, and I'm just gonna add these 2 roofing pieces right on the edges. I'm gonna take this same one and then pull it all the way across, but here we can add some roof paint in the middle. So I'm gonna pick my least favorite glass roofing option, which I think is this one. I'm adding on some roof paint, and now we have an interesting looking roof. I'll add some trim, and then we can even make it look a little more interesting here at the front by adding some wall pieces. So our door can be right in the center there. It's gonna look a little more modern, and I think I'm also gonna make a bump out right here. I'm adding another roofing piece to the side. Wait, does this roofing come with skylights? How did I never notice that before? The werewolf's roofing has skylights built in. That's so cool. They actually have this one with an accidental skylight, or they have one without. I had no idea. Also, this swatch is hands down the ugliest, so maybe I have to go with that. Now we have to find an ugly door. Which one on here is the worst? I feel like most people would argue Realm of Magic, but Realm of Magic has such a soft spot for me. I actually saw a post the other day showing like potential inspiration for Realm of Magic doors, and it made me appreciate them so much more. If only they were actually that pretty, but still. Ooh, we do have this one. This is from Fitness Stuff. I really don't like that door, so let's try that one. I'm looking for a weird exterior paint. This one is definitely in the running from Outdoor Retreat. Something about the texture of this to me is just a little off. That or like any of these base game ones, I never use these. Or there's also this wood from base game which only comes in one swatch. I started looking at windows and tell me this is not the worst one in the game. I feel like you could also debate the realm of magic ones, but I use these ones all the time, so like I'd be lying if I said I don't like these. This, however, I don't even like looking at it, but I think if we use these, I'm gonna have to change my roof paint. Let's do something black instead. I'm going to add a black trim. I've used black wood on the entry, and I'm thinking about making a garden over here. Along the sides, I'm using these windows from Eco Lifestyle. I feel like they'll complement our ugly windows well. And then up top, we need another weird window. Honestly, any of the get to work ones are pretty terrible. This get together one is also super weird. Although, I could turn it around and have that weird part on the inside, and then I don't have to worry about it right now. I'll have to worry about it here, but maybe we can cover it up somehow. We'll have the weird get to work ones over here, and then, ooh, I will definitely be paying for this later, but it's a later problem. And then for my back door, this get together one is also very terrible. Okay, so we have all of our ugly items on there. Now I'm gonna try and add some details and landscaping and stuff to see if we can pull it all together somehow. And I moved all of my weird items to the back, so I'm gonna start to bring these out. Maybe I could put one of these statues right here, or we just lean into it and add two. I feel like a chimney could help, and my least favorite one is probably this one from base game. I've added a ladder leading up to our garden, and then I made this small deck in the back, and that's where our eco lifestyle stuff will go. And then we could line up all of this stuff like under here. My statue could go right at the front, and then I think our city living couch can go like under here. Oh, look at that, the city living couch has friends. For outdoor lighting, it's again probably gonna be some of the get to work items. The thing with get to work is a lot of the items were very much meant for industrial or like commercial lots, which is fine, but when you try and build a house with them, it can be questionable. Okay, it's coming together a little bit. I need a window box that I don't like. I do find this one here hard to use from get together, but we could use that here to cover up the windows. Oh, this from Journey to Bed 2. I'm putting that over top of my door, which doesn't look that bad. Let me tell you what's gonna save the day here. Ponds. This is looking not great, but it's nothing a good pond can't fix. We're gonna raise up the water going around here. Let's add some paint to it. Does this make it worse? I also want to add a table out here. We could do... Honestly, a lot of the tables aren't that bad. Actually, let's do a growing together one. And we could also possibly do some of the round furniture. I remember saying when this pack came out that I thought this furniture was super random. It's supposed to be for a recreation center, but even then, I just hate the way it looks. You know what? This might end up being our dining table. We'll just get the woodworking table out here. We'll just add some more little sculptures that possibly they've invented. What is this thing supposed to be? From Strangerville? Oh, and the bathtub. Oh no. Okay, I do still have to create a rooftop garden, so I'm gonna add that bathtub there. I didn't have a door here because of the ladder, but maybe I will add one. Just like a door leading in like that. We could add some of the rougher looking gardening boxes upstairs. I wanted to literally add plants up here. Oh look, we even have a smaller version of this. The smaller version isn't that bad, but I guess I'm gonna use the whole set. I'm also using this planter from fitness stuff, these bushes from base game. Oh, I forgot about this from city living too. Ooh, okay, I guess it's gonna have to go maybe over here. So this is how the outside turned out. Listen, I really think if we had different windows, it wouldn't be so bad. I tried adding some normalcy with the eco lifestyle ones just to like, we needed a hero, but I feel like even that didn't help. But I do like the landscape going around, and the sculptures don't actually look too bad. I feel like this top wallpaper is also screwing us a little bit. I don't even hate our city living couch area. Coming around this side, we have our rooftop garden. I tried adding like the ugliest plants I could find, including these window boxes from Get to Work. And then coming around in the back, we have all of our eco lifestyle objects, our weird things that maybe we've invented. It could just be a big Star Wars fan that lives here. Okay, let's go inside. I'm terrified for the interior. I've already added my dining table there, and I've done a layout, so we're gonna have a kid's room. That'll be over to the left with the weird windows, and then up top is where where we're gonna have our main bedroom. Look at these interior windows. Oh no. And we're gonna have a bathroom over here too. I've added my stairs right in the middle here leading up. All right, starting on the interior, the worst doors I think are again probably the ones from Get to Work. So I'm gonna attempt to use them both in the white swatch. For flooring for the main room, I think the worst wood option we have is probably Realm of Magic. I also actually really don't like the island living one. Something about the texture of these bothers me. Same as this base game one, I feel like we could get away with this. And then for wallpaper, I would really like to avoid something with patterns because we have a lot of patterns happening from the door and the window. However, I think most of the ugly ones are going to be in wallpaper. Like, I saw a lot of people hating on this one. Maybe I'll use that one in a bathroom. There is also a lot of hate for this wallpaper, which we could use in the kids' room, or I could bring this upstairs and use it in my bedroom. I think I'm gonna have to do that. Then for the main room, oh, this one is bad. This one is very bad. And I think we're gonna have to go with white flooring if we're gonna do it. I'm trying to keep with just the plainest platform paint ever. And let's start off with our living room. I think I might section this off here so that I can add my TV on this wall. And then we can maybe turn this part into part of the bathroom here. And because of the way I have my platforms, this could be a sunken living room. I saw people hating on this couch, but I think this is gonna be perfect for our living room. It's giving that like atomic 50s sort of vibe, which I actually think is gonna match our crazy wallpaper. We also have a matching chair, so I'm gonna use these two in black. I don't really think we have any ugly TVs, although this one's definitely my least favorite. Or this one, I just don't like those things that stick out. So maybe we'll add that. And what about ugly fireplaces? By the way, I'm saying ugly, but if there's anything you guys see here that you're like, oh, I actually really like that, it's totally fine. When I posted that on Twitter, I saw tons of items that I actually like. Everyone has a different style, so I'm definitely not judging if you like a lot of these items. I've got a weird taste myself. So I think we're going base game fireplace here. And then for rugs, I don't really like this one. Ooh, and I really don't like this one here from base game either. So we're gonna use it. For my coffee table, I'm gonna use this one here from City Living. It reminds me of the new Twitter. I think I have to add this weird eco lifestyle lamp somewhere. You would think this was a wall lamp or a table lamp, but it just goes on the floor. I guess I could make it a table lamp though. I'll raise it up. We'll put it on our coffee table. And then what if we change our lighting? By the way, the family that was living on this lot before is like Marcus Flex, three other male werewolves. One of them, I believe, is his brother, and three dogs. Anyway. Oh, what about this? This is from Growing Together. It's another one that's meant to be for a recreational center. And if we manipulate the lighting, maybe the color won't be as bad in here. Why am I starting to like this? I need a weird mirror for the front. And what about some bad art? I feel like we've got a ton of this in this game. Like this here, again, from Get to Work. The fact that it's just a picture of the couch is so funny. I think it's meant for retail. And we're gonna try and find a plant, which I think we could probably use one of these ones from Journey to Batu. I'm adding some lighting, sculptures. What if we added this pig? Look at its little butt. Also, this Strangerville sculpture, like what even is that? I'm gonna save that for this room. Okay, so for now, this is what our living room looks like. I have room for a bookshelf, so maybe I'll use one of those from Growing Together. And I'm gonna add this base game lamp here too. Oh wait, I just remembered all of these weird base game lamps. Okay, no, there we go for now. Let's turn around. I've already got my dining table, so I think we could fit my kitchen right here. What is the worst fridge? I want to say this one from Get to Work. What's even in there? Yeah, it's like medicine. Makes sense for its purpose, but as my household fridge, it's pretty weird. So let's do my fridge there. And then for counters, oh no. I think Realm of Magic is probably the worst. Or honestly, one of the like corporate base game ones. That's probably the worst one for a house, right? The worst oven is definitely the used one from City Living. So let's maybe put that over here. And now I'm thinking maybe I should have used the used fridge. Maybe that one is worse. Okay, used fridge. Why don't we have a matching swatch for the oven? Okay, whatever. Used fridge, used stove, bathroom sink. We could probably get an island going. My table still has a lot of room. And the worst chairs are definitely Get to Work. I feel like I'm doing an award show. And the worst chair goes to Get to Work. This is probably the worst trash can. I'm gonna put that over to the side a little more. And we need a bad circle rug to go under my dining table. I saw people saying that this one was ugly. I like this one, but I get it. So I'm gonna put it underneath my table. I also saw a lot of hate for hutches. I don't know why. Maybe because we have too many of them. Honestly, I get this one though. Those plates look so off. I'm gonna put this one in one of the corners. We'll put two of them with the green plates. Maybe some clutter around will help. I'm gonna add a laptop, a lamp. Actually, this lamp can go over in the living room, and I've never noticed that, but that is a pretty bad lamp. I think I'll use this plant here as my centerpiece from Eco Lifestyle. I actually don't hate this one. I just don't like how you can't change the swatch of the flowers, just the vase. This one from Eco Lifestyle is also so weird. I'm gonna put that in here. It's funny because Eco Lifestyle is one of my favorite building packs, but there are just a couple very questionable items. Oh, and this lamp from City Living. For final items, I'm adding this wall decor from Dine Out, this art from Kids Room Stuff. Oh, this art too. This art has to go somewhere. I guess I'll also add this wall bench here from Get to Work just because I need something there. And I think I'm gonna shrink this from City Living, and I'm just gonna use that as decor. And here is our kitchen and dining room. Not the worst. That window there is definitely helping versus the other window, which is making it worse. It's 100% weird. There's no way around that, but part of me likes it. I don't know. Maybe I've just been looking at it too long, but I do feel like it could be a lot worse. All right, let's go do the kids' room over here. So we are gonna use the balloons here from High School Years, which is so funny because I actually love these too. I'm changing the lighting colors in here as well. One bed I really don't like is this one. There is also a smaller version of it in base game. Maybe I'll do like two beds here. And in here, we can add the My First Pet Stuff couches. Actually, this one isn't bad at all. If it's right in this little spot, there are definitely some weird swatches in here, but this one in black isn't bad. I got rid of the other bed and just put one under here, and I'm thinking this could look better if it was colorful. Like, we just absolutely lean into the blue. Oh, this dresser, this cats and dogs dresser is definitely up there for me. I think there's actually another one. Oh, it's an end table. Okay, let's get rid of the base game end table and we'll replace it for this one. I don't like using these kids room stuff rugs. I saw people hating on the egg bed, which was very controversial. I love the egg bed. It's actually one of my favorite items. So I'm gonna add two of them. I need a stand-up mirror. I feel like the worst one is probably this base game one. Oh, and I'm sorry, but any of the tooth things from Growing Together, I can't. I totally get the tooth fairy thing, but did we really need all of these tooth fairy pictures? No. I guess we should actually add some kids' toys. So I'm gonna add this modern dollhouse. I have never liked this one. I always thought it was a hospital, but it's not. Apparently it's a fantasy home. That looks like a hospital. Come on. I'm also gonna add this toy box. This guy's name is Tentacle Tom. I don't like it. I do not like it. We're adding two Tentacle Toms. Maybe we can actually also add some pet toys in here. So it'll be like kid toy box, and then there'll be pet toy box. And I feel like since there's fish on the ground, we need to get a fish bowl. I also saw a lot of hate for base game curtains, so I'm gonna throw some of these in here. Okay, here is our kids' room. This one is rough. This one, I don't like a single thing in here other than the egg dog beds. And I will die on that hill. At least we're keeping the blue throughout. I also can't stand these windows. I'm so over them. But there we go. We've got a kid's room. Let's go and do the bathroom next. And in here, we're gonna see a lot of the Eco Lifestyle bathroom plumbing. Specifically, this sink and this toilet. Both of them are so weird, but they actually match my aesthetic a little bit. I found this base game mirror. I'm gonna add one of the shelves that I've been using on top. And they also have a matching bathtub, although I feel like the bathtub isn't too bad. A lot of people were also hating on the swan bathtub from Get Famous, which again, I like it. And I saw a lot of hate for the peacock sink, which I cannot add this one in here. I love this sink, especially in that swatch. Like, I think it's so pretty. So, okay, Eco Lifestyle bathroom set. I'll add my toilet paper, maybe this shower caddy. I also really don't like this here from Parenthood. The white swatch isn't bad, but all of the other ones, like, I just don't like the swatches on it. What else? This towel thing, also questionable. Maybe I'll add that instead of my shelf that I had. These towels specifically. Oh, and I don't like this hamper either because it's pointless, but I don't want to make this not functional here. We could bring the hamper upstairs and put it in the bedroom. I also don't like this mat here from Get Together, so this is what I'm gonna use as my bath mat. And let's maybe add some more weird get to work art. Oh, I hate it. I hate it. Maybe I can use this massive light here to change the lighting. Okay, there we go. This is going to be our bathroom. I did also make a basement, and I was thinking down here we could do an entire Star Wars shrine. Just to tie it all together, outside we had that Star Wars area, so I think we should make that downstairs. This time we can use the polka dot wallpaper, and let's make ourselves a shrine. Honestly, this might end up looking cool. I never realized how much I don't like these lamps. This is the size they are normally. I could shrink them twice and they would still look weird. I could also add one of the Journey to Batuu rugs. Okay, I'll admit this is actually pretty sick. Add some mirrors in here and this is going to come alive. There's not really much to do down here. This is basically just going to be a shrine. Perhaps they've created all of these items. That would be impressive, honestly. Good for them. I can appreciate this room. The only thing left to do now is the upstairs of this house. Ooh, I forgot about those windows. What bad wallpaper have I not used yet? I did use this one, so we don't have to reuse it. Oh, the sailboat one is pretty bad. I forgot all about the sailboat one. Maybe that can go in my bathroom. I don't think I can do it. That one might just be too ugly. The Get Famous one is pretty rough. I think I'll use that for my bathroom upstairs. Wait, what about this one? This is just a base game wallpaper. Like, again, these things do make sense in a factory, but in my home, awful choice. But I actually think we could make something good here, so let me find a bed. Oh, this one, this one. My windows come out so far, my bed has to be so far away from the wall, but we could possibly use this as a shelf. I'm gonna raise up this strange school mascot action figure. Oh, this also from Journey to Batuu. Also this thing, maybe this could be my end table. Then we could raise up another lamp on top. This base game mirror bothers me so much because it's so high up on the wall, but it actually fits between those windows. For my dresser, I'm thinking either one of these base game ones, specifically this one because the swatch isn't right in the menu and it hasn't been right for so long, or you know what, we're also gonna bring in this one. My rug is gonna be this one here from City Living, but I always forget this one has a bunch of swatches hidden underneath and some of them are cute. I don't like that one though. Oh, this get to work plant, I can't believe I didn't use that earlier. And this spa day one, I saw a lot of hate for these pictures, which actually match my bathroom. But also any of these motivational pictures, they remind me of my fifth grade classroom. That hamper I brought upstairs is gonna go right here. I think I could probably fit a TV in here. And I think I have to add one of these speakers, like these ones. These from City Living are just so dated to me. Same as these ones from Base Game. I guess I could also use the corner couch from My First Pet Stuff since we didn't use it downstairs. And I'm gonna use some of these Base Game wall lights. Oh, and this chair, hold on. This chair totally fits the downstairs vibe, giving that like spacey theme. I guess I could just pull this over a little and then I have some more room for it. Maybe I'll add a speaker down here so there would be something to do other than just sit. I'm using this base game end table here, some more Star Wars decor. And again, why do I like this bedroom? The wallpaper actually looks good in here, I think. And for some reason, the windows didn't turn out as bad as I thought they would. It's interesting, definitely not my taste, but it's not awful. Let's go ahead and finish off this bathroom here. Oh, you know what? We could pull off a whole industrial bathroom. I'm gonna use some worn flooring from City Living. I guess we'll use a black and gold. My toilet will be this one from Get to Work. Oh, what if we did the dine out industrial sink with just a base game mirror, this plant, and also this City Living bathtub. I would have also loved to include some of these City Living pictures here, like the big ones. So I just added one there to my bedroom. Oh, I'm adding the dog picture in the bathroom too. And this rug from Get Together, I'm gonna use that as my bath mat. Okay, so here's my bathroom. The wallpaper is horrible, but I like that we managed to match our wallpaper and our window with our shower. Considering we had to use only the ugliest items in the whole game, the interior is not horrible. It's definitely not pretty, but it was fun to try and create this. Let me know what you guys think. Let me know what some of your least favorite items are in The Sims 4. And if you saw some in here that you like, let me know. I had some in here that I like too. If you guys like the video, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. subscribe, and thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you in the next one.